Hello and welcome back to the FPGA PS channel. In the previous video, we implemented the MicroBlaze in the Vivado and we connected to the DDR, to the external DDR over the mic, and we also connected other external peripherals like the UART and AXI timer to our MicroBlaze. We also saw that how we can embed the AXI Ethernet that contains the Mac in our Vivado design. So our Vivado design is ready. And today we are going to use the FreeRTOS as the operating system and we will run the echo server application on the heart of the MicroBlaze. Here is the main picture of our scenario. We will run the server in our evaluation board, that is AC701, and we have a client that is running in our PC. We will run the Python as the client and they will start to send and receive the data over the Ethernet connection. We use the TCP as the fundamental networking protocol to make the connection between the client and the server. The question here is how we should write the whole TCP protocol. For sure, it's such a difficult job. The answer is that we are going to use the lightweight IP, LWIP, that implement essential feature of the various networking protocols like TCP or UDP. It's widely adapted, it's open source, so you can easily take the advantage of that, and is designed for the embedded system. And it also needs only the tens of the kilobyte of the RAM, so that's why it's suitable for the embedded ARM cores or for the MicroBlaze. The Xilinx Vitis IDE comes with the TCP LWIP Eco Server template. So we don't need to do anything, we just use that template and it will run the Echo server in our embedded system, in our FPGA or evaluation board. So as you can see here, the Echo server simply received the data, it copied them to the TX buffer and it will send them back to our host machine. So let's review this scenario again here. The host machine will send some information, for example here, the string of hello world. It will send it to the echo server, it will receive and be written in the RX buffer, and then it will be copied to the TX buffer, and then it will send back to our client. And then the client will receive the exact data. That's how does the echo server work. The main important point here is to learn how we can have access first to that RX buffer and the TX buffer, and how does this echo server work. For example, if you want to send some data from the host machine to the PL side of the FPGA, you will send them to the server and they are saved in your RX buffer, and then you can easily send that RX buffer to the PL side. Or if you have some data from the PL side that you want to send them to your host machine, you need to first save them to that TX buffer and then send them to that host machine. In this example, the evaluation board AC701 is directly connected to my laptop PC by the help of the Ethernet cable. And we launch the Echo server application and we run it on the AC701 and we run the Python in the PC as the client. Now let's go to the Vitis IDE and start our application design. I experienced some unknown bug when I was working with Vivado 2024 and FreeRTOS, and that's why here I'm going to use the Vivado 2022.1. We start with creating the new application project and we create a new platform by selecting the XSA that we exported from the Vivado. Now we can go to the next step. As you can see here, the MicroBlaze 0 is directly selected as your processor since we don't have any other processor in our Vivado design. You have two options here. You can select the standalone or FreeRTOS, but running the LWIP on the FreeRTOS is much easier and I'm going to use the FreeRTOS here. You can see all the provided templates from the Vitis IDE. And I need to use the FreeRTOS LWIP Echo server. It completely creates an application project for us and it already includes all the necessary files. I want to modify a bit the board support package. We select modified board support package setting and we can see that LWIP is already added to our board support package. My board is directly connected to my computer, so I don't need the DHCP, and I will deactivate DHCP since I don't need it. Echo server application contains two important C files that if you learn how to work with them, you can easily manage your data movement between the board and your host PC. The first one is the main.c, and I'm going to explain to you the important sections of the main.c. The first section is the place that you can set your IP address, the netmask, and the gateway, and you can change them based on your application requirement. And the next section is the place that it creates a new thread and they run the Echo application in the new thread for us. The next one and the heart of the Echo server is the echo.c, and it contains all the important functions that you need to send and receive the data to your PC. The echo.c contains a process that handles an individual client connections. It has the main loop, as you can see that here, it has a main loop. That main loop continuously processes the receive and the transmitted data. It contains two important functions. The first function is the read function. It receives the data from the client and it will write them to the receive buffer. The next one is the write function, and it will write back the received data buffer to the client. So two important functions that you need to learn how to work with them. The first one is the read and the second one is the write. Here, because we are working with the Echo server, the received buffer and the TX buffer are equal. For sure, we can have two different buffers, and in the future examples that I will provide to you, you will see how you can benefit from the two buffers, and you can have a separated RX buffer and the TX buffer. Here you can see the echo C without applying any modification. You can see the while one loop. You can see the read function that it will receive the data from the client. And you can see the write function that it will send the data to the client. I'm going to build and then run the application on my evaluation board. After launching the application, we can see that MicroBlaze prints the configured IP, netmask, and the gateway in the UART terminal, and we need to wait a bit until the file auto negotiation is completed. Alright, the auto negotiation is also completed, and you can see the port and IP number of the server. We should be able to easily ping our server. We can ping our server, and it shows that our design in Vivado and the Vitis is completely functional and working fine. I provided two projects on the GitHub, and you can find the link of the GitHub repository on the description. And each project contains two important files, echo.c and pythoncode.py. We need to replace the echo.c in the Vitis application and rebuild the project. And we run the pythoncode.py on the PC as the client. In the first project, the Python code that is running as the client on the PC will send the string to our server. Then the server will add a suffix, will add another piece of the string to receive it data, and it will send it back to our Python client. And then the Python will display the received data. This simple example shows us how we can have two different RX and the TX buffer. I'm going to implement and run the first project. So I will copy the echo.c from here and delete the default echo C in the Vitis IDE and easily paste the provided echo.c file. If you look at the first echo.c file, we can see the suffix here. We can see that we have two different buffer. We have receive buffer and we have a send buffer, and we can see that we are adding the suffix to the receive buffer, and I save it in the send buffer. You can also again see the read function and the write function, and here the read and the write functions are working with the two different buffer. The read function is working with the receive buffer. It will receive the data from the Python client and write them into the receive buffer, and the write function will send the send buffer to to the Python client. After changing the echo.c file, we need to rebuild our project again. And again, we will launch the application as the hardware on the evaluation board. After application completely launched on the evaluation board, I can go and run the Python code on my PC. So I'm here in the project one. I open the CMD window, and by the help of the command, I can run my Python code. After I run the first Python code, it first shows that it connected to the server. It sent the hello server to the evaluation board. It shows that the sending data is completed and it received the data. And it also displayed the received data. And at the end, it will close the connection. In the second example, I try to show that how can I send a buffer that contains some integer data from my PC as the client to the evaluation board as the server and receive the data in the evaluation board. Then I will do the small modification. For example, here I will calculate the absolute value of the received data and I will multiply them by a constant value, and then I will send back the data to the client and I will also display the received data. This example can be the start point that shows us how we can display or send the data to the evaluation board by the help of the Ethernet protocol. Here again, I'm in the second project folder. I copy the second echo.c file and I will replace the echo.c that I have in the Vitis application. I delete the file and I easily replace the new echo.c. It's really useful also to have a look at this echo.c file. You can see that I have two buffers, receive buffer and the send buffer. The read function will receive the information, will receive the buffer from the client, and it will write it into the receive buffer. And here is performing the small digital signal processing, a small operation on the received data, and is saving them into the send buffer. And then the write function is sending back the information to the client. Again, here I'm going to build the application and then launch the application as the hardware on the evaluation board. All right, after my application completely launched on the evaluation board, I can go and run the second Python code. Again, here I will open the CMD window and I will run the second Python code. First, it connects to the server at the given IP. It sends the data. It also displays the sent data here. As you can see, the display data is the sine wave. And then it receives the data and displays them for us.